My name is Marianna Fontana. I am a professor of cardiology at the National Amyloidosis Centre in London and professor at the University College London. Today we reported the interim analysis at 18 months of the phase 3 Apollo B study, a study assessing the patisiran against placebo over 12 months of double-blind period that showed benefit in patients with ATTR cardiomyopathy. So here we assess the 18 months analysis during the open label extension, and we report the changes from baseline to 18 months in the 6-minute walking test, KCCQ overall score, and NT-proBNP and troponin I levels. So patisiran is a small interference RNA, and what it does, it leads to degradation of the mRNA with reduction in production of the protein. And so it interferes with a crucial step in the main mechanism that is responsible for the clinical phenotype and the prognosis in patients with ATTR amyloidosis, which is the production of transthyretin and then deposition as amyloid. So Apollo B is a phase 3 randomized placebo-controlled trial in 360 patients with ATTR cardiomyopathy, with wild-type or variant disease with cardiomyopathy and heart failure symptoms. So patients, after having completed the 12 months of double-blind period where they were randomized to patisiran or placebo, entered the open-label extension. And here we report the analysis at 18 after all patients have completed the 18 months visit. So the findings to date is that the treatment with patisiran compared to placebo, the beneficial effects were confirmed during this analysis. So we confirmed the results that were already seen at the end of the double-blind period, but this is an extension with the open-label extension at 18 months. So we confirmed the findings, but also we have seen that in patients who were initially randomized to placebo did not fully recover what they lost in terms of functional capacity and quality of life, highlighting how important it is to initiate the treatment early in this population. So basically, it confirmed the benefit of patisiran, the safety profile, but also it confirms the importance of early treatment initiation. So in this specific trial, we didn't do any subgroup analysis in this sense, but as a clinician working with these patients every day, I would prescribe this drug across all patients with ATTR cardiomyopathy and symptomatic heart failure. So the next step is to follow up these patients for the 36 months of the open label extension period and to follow up all these different endpoints. So starting from the 6-minute walking test, KCCQ overall score, NT-proBNP troponin, but also mortality and hospitalization to 36 months and see the overall trend.